Hello and welcome to 1000 Word Interviews. My name's Mordecai and today I'm joined by Mo.
G'day.
G'day, thank you so much for doing this interview.
Thanks for coming up.
No worries. And to get started, can you just tell us a few things about yourself?
Yes, so I am a full-time musician. That's multifaceted, so I do performing and teaching and videos, and filmmaking. Yeah, just kind of juggling different crafts. Trying to make a living as a artist. It's pretty hard, but at the moment I'm making it work.
Okay, good. Sounds interesting. And what kind of music do you make?
I make various kinds, like electronic music, guitar-focused kind of psychedelic rock music, experimental music, absurdist comical music, using random objects and, yeah, kind of skit-themed. Like silly stuff.
Okay. Bit of everything.
Yeah.
Okay, good. Well, today we're going to speak about a photo of yours with an interesting story. But before we start talking about the photo, can you give us a few clues as to some of the themes that we're going to talk about?
Okay. Travel.
Okay.
Yep, this one. Performance. Music, obviously. Themes.
They're three good ones.
Sport ties into it loosely.
Okay.
Yeah, it's connected. Yeah.
Okay. So yep. Travel, performance, music, and sport.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. Well, let's get started. First question, could you just describe what we can see in the photo?
Okay, so it's a Polaroid shot someone gave to me after I performed, and it's just me drumming on some random objects with a suitcase in a narrow street.
Okay, very good. So what are some of those random objects that you're drumming?
I can see in the picture some salad bowls, some buckets, and I think that's a water dispenser bottle, the blue things, Piccadilly ones. I think that's everything I can see, and the drumsticks.
Okay, yeah, very good.
But there's definitely more going on outside the shop.
Okay. We'll hear more about that. And you've already asked this, but who can we see in the photo?
Me. Yep.
And easy question. And where was this photo taken?
Lisbon, Portugal.
Okay.
In Barrio, Alto.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And when was this photo taken?
2016. In about July, August 2016.
There, wow. So it's a few years old.
Listen.
And what was actually happening in the moment that this photo was taken? What were you doing?
So that very moment, I was drumming, busking, performing, whatever you want to call it. In the main part, kind of nightlife precinct of Lisbon.
Yeah.
Late at night. And it was the same night that Portugal won the Euro Cup in the soccer.
Okay.
So the town was absolutely mental.
Okay. Yeah.
So if you zoomed out from that shot, there'd be like hundreds of people just like yelling and screaming and dancing.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you were performing. You used an interesting word, busking. What is busking?
Busking is, I guess it's an old word for street theatre.
Okay.
Yeah. I don't even know where it originates, but it's, yeah, essentially it's street theatre in a nutshell.
So it's like performing on the street in public.
Mm-hmm.
So you were busking, you were playing these random objects, and there were people everywhere.
Mm-hmm.
Because Portugal had just won the Euro Cup.
Literally an hour or two earlier.
Okay.
Yeah. And I was not planning on busking.
Yeah.
And then it was just so mental in the streets that I just thought, why not try it?
Yeah.
And it was hilarious.
Okay.
Yeah.
So in that case, now we're going to talk a little bit more about the story of this photo.
Mm-hmm.
So I have a few questions. First of all, why did you start drumming or busking on objects instead of drums?
It started out just as a kind of experiment. It was a, yeah, like, could street performing is actually quite difficult to get an audience doing something normal. Because everyone's seen everything, like a singer playing guitar.
Mm.
So I thought, how can I create a bit of a unique act.
Right.
So I experimented with just a few buckets and saucepans, and it just kind of grew from there.
Okay.
Yeah.
So this is something you do regularly.
Mm-hmm.
What are some of the objects that you sometimes use to play drums on?
So buckets are the kind of foundation, and then it all stems from that. So there'll be saucepans and old like kitchen items, bits of broken metal that come from like building sites.
Yeah.
Traffic cones. They use power tools. Kind of, I've just developed this big cacophony of random objects.
Okay.
Into this show. Yeah. It's kind of, it's grown over the years. It's taken a few years to get to where it is.
Okay. Well,
yeah.
So you're still performing in this way at the moment?
Yeah.
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 And what kind of music do you play on all of these random objects?
It's kind of, well, I guess in simple terms, dance music.
Okay.
Because I'm limited to two arms. And so it kind of has to be simple and minimalistic. And a lot of dance like techno and trance or whatever you want to call those, or the house music, it's all a 4-4 beat.
Yeah.
So it's, like, so it's, you can kind of do that with two arms, whereas other kind of music is more complicated and you need both feet.
Okay.
Yeah.
Ah, because you're sort of squatting down, so you can't use your feet to play drums. Oh, only your arms.
I could get a kick drum, a bass drum, but it would just become much more difficult to transport everything.
Okay.
But it might be something I'll do in the future.
Okay, cool. And just to return to this photo on this night when you were busking in Portugal and they had won the Euro, can you tell us more about the night?
Mm, yeah. So, I'd been in Lisbon maybe a week or two by then.
Mm.
So I'd kind of played around a bit in some of the areas, but I hadn't played up in Barrio, Alto. And if anyone's been there, they would know Barrio Alto is the kind of main nightlife area.
Okay.
Or one of. Yeah. And so two friends from Australia happened to be in Lisbon at the time. So we would kind of watch the game in a bar. Mm. And it was pretty wild because everyone was just going nuts.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm not a massive soccer follower, but it was great to see how crazy people go. Because it's such, everyone's so passionate. Yeah, it was wild.
And sorry to interrupt. Who did they actually beat?
I can't remember.
Okay.
I reckon it was France.
Okay.
It's going back six, seven years. Pretty sure it was France.
Okay.
And it was close. Like, it was down to the kind of, like, it wasn't a thrashing. It was.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I remember, like, Cristiano Ronaldo being a big deal.
Okay.
Yeah.
So,
I like soccer and I play it socially, but.
Yeah.
I wasn't like aware of the significance. And then when they won, from the minute they won, the whole city was ballistic. Nuts. Everyone was like honking and flying flags and scarves, and they were singing, they were screaming, Portugal ale, Portugal ale. Like the whole city.
And what does that mean?
I don't know.
Okay.
Obviously something to do with Portugal being great.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, we should research that.
But it was just the whole night, like honking and, it was ballistic. And then in the area where the photo's taken, there's no cars, so it was just people on foot.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool.
But it was busy. It was very busy.
Wow. No, it sounds like a crazy night.
Yeah.
And a good set of coincidences that led you to be playing in this particular moment.
Yeah.
And I have one final question.
Mm-hmm.
What's something that you're looking forward to in the future that may or may not have to do with the photo?
Going back to Europe.
Okay.
Yeah. And doing another busking tour.
Cool.
Yeah. So, I might go to places. I've been several times, but I might choose a destination I hadn't been before, like Ireland or maybe Scandinavia.
Okay. And
we'll see.
And when are you going to do that?
Next year.
Next year.
So I guess next summer.
Okay.
Yeah.
Cool. Well, thank you so much for doing this interview and sharing the story. It's been a lot of fun.
Cool.
And I've enjoyed it a lot. So,
yeah,
thank you.
Awesome. Thanks for having me.
No worries. And thank you all for watching. As always, you can find all of the questions and answers from our conversation below in the description. And you can also find a small lesson plan if you happen to be an English teacher. So, yeah. Cheers, Damo. We're done. And, yeah, see you later.
Thank you.